All right, folks, there we are. Zeppola or Zeppole, Zeppola di Bacala, and our bacala salad with cannellini beans, our octopus salad with bucatini. All right, so here we have some nice, beautiful blanched garlic. We've got the, I've also added some scallions, some green onion to this, so we'll mix that all in. We're going to use the rest of that bacala, the dried salted cod that we let soak for 3 days in several changes of water. We're going to flake that off in here, and I want to show you what it looks like when it's flaked. This is the bacala that is flaked. We're going to add this to our batter over here, and I put some green onion in that. So here, let us slowly add that to there. The oil is hot enough. Two ways of using your dried salted cod after you have rehydrated it for 3 days and several changes of water. Look at the inside of that. That's nice and good fritter. Zeppola donut. Absolutely tasty. When I say arancini, I mean arancini. Isn't that beautiful? Today we're cooking with Gabriel's Supermarket. Gabriel's Supermarkets, the one in Scotia and the one in Rotterdam, have all the products necessary to make most Italian dishes. Especially the one we're going to make here today, which is a Sicilian dish, arancini. Now, to make arancini, there are so many different methods that people use. I'm going to show you one here today that you can make three different types of arancini without having to just make the typical ragu. Today, instead of using ground beef, we're going to use sausage. So here we have some sausage already browned off, and then we drain this in a strainer to get all the extra grease out of that. And you can see that the sausage is it's fully cooked and there's no grease on the side of the bowl. Now, here's what I want to show you, and the fact that we picked up at Gabriel's some prosciutto di Parma, and this is the actual prosciutto from Parma, Italy. We were going to buy the domestic, and we said, no, let's go with the real stuff. The prosciutto with mozzarella cheese, that's another one, and that's going to be done with an Alfredo. Okay, here is our ricotta salata. So when we do our eggplant, and we saute the eggplant for 3 to 4 minutes to dice, we're going to peel and dice that eggplant. We're going to use this filling, part of this, one-third of this filling, with some ricotta salata. This is a wonderful cheese that we actually picked up at Capri Imports Italian Deli. And then we're going to have that filling. All right, so now our ingredients, our filling for our arancini is cooled down and we have it all mixed. This is our ragu with the sausage. And I mixed the shredded mozzarella right in there with some pecorino romano. So we've got our ragu there for the sausage here. I left a little bit of prosciutto di Parma on top to show you that this has an Alfredo. And it's got the peas and the base mixture of what we put. We're going to mix that prosciutto di Parma into that one. And that's going to be our Alfredo one. Here is our eggplant. And I put the eggplant there so that if you're filling and you've got a bunch of people working in the kitchen, they'll remember, oh, this one is the eggplant filling for the arancini. And here we have the ricotta salata. You can see how nice and light that is. That's in there, and that's the eggplant with our pea and tomato and Trinity Mirepoix base. So we're going to put some regular whole milk mozzarella. Here's our filling for our long hot peppers. We have them split. I removed most of the seeds from them. And here we're going to add something to the sausage filling. We're going to add sausage and prosciutto di Parma with the ricotta cheese and the mozzarella, and then some pecorino romano and breadcrumbs to bind all that. And we're going to fill them and finish. We're going to put them in the oven at 350 degrees for about 35 to 40 minutes. And they're going to firm right up. And that's a great stuffed long hot peppers. So we're going to get our rice all together in a bowl. And we're going to get a bowl of water, because when we make the arancini, what we want to do is we want to wet our hands and we want to make a pancake, thick pancake shape in our palm, small pancake in our palm, and then add our filling that's all mixed up to the, on top of that, and then make a top with a little another ball, like a little hat for the arancini, and then we're going to form them in our hands. Here I have some fresh mint that I'm going to mix into the Alfredo one with the prosciutto di Parma. I also added the rest of that eggplant to make a ratatouille, and we're going to add our San Marzano tomatoes to that. We're going to split them and dice them up and get that all olive oil and herbs and throw that in the oven, and that's going to roast off. And we've got our polenta over there. So we can also make our kale and cannellini. We've left the left sausage to make kale and cannellini with sausage. And we got enough vegetables back there, roasted red pepper to add to that to make it very colorful as well as tasty. So let's get started here. Okay, so let's make some more arancini here. Get our hands wet. We see we have our stuffed long hots that are done. They look beautiful with the little breadcrumb on the topping. On the top of them, and we're going to have a stop in a minute and have a couple of those as a snack. But our hands are wet. What we want to do is take a little bit of this saffron rice, and we want to get it formed into a pancake shape. Make a little indentation here. We're going to take a little bit of the ragu again. We're going to make another ragu one. Take the back of your spoon. You can pile that right up in there as such. Okay. Wet your fingers. Make a little hat. You can use the other part of your palm. Okay. Then come right up. Right up. With your hat. And squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. Press and squeeze. And if you notice how I'm cupping my heart shape here in my hand, I'm already forming the cone shape upside down. So you can continue to squeeze that, press it in. As such. Now when these sit up for 24 hours in the refrigerator, tomorrow when we put them in the flour and water slurry, the pastella, and then roll them into the breadcrumbs and fry them at 350-356 degrees Fahrenheit in canola oil in that big yellow pot over there, or the red one there, we're going to use a spider strainer until 5 to 7 minutes is all I really need. Somewhere you're going to want to check them, because once they start to really brown, everything's already cooked, so you don't really have to leave it in the oil for 7 minutes. You can maybe 4 minutes, it might be done. I gotta tell you, these stuffed long hot peppers are out of this world.
out of this world with the prosciutto, the Parma, and the Italian sausage, with ricotta cheese, and whole milk mozzarella, and pecorino romano, and breadcrumbs. Oh my gosh. Look at this thing. So, you know, arancini, it was originated in Sicily in the 10th century when Sicily was under Arab rule. And your arancini, your rice balls, Sicilian style, are cone-shaped, and then they're put into they're not put into egg wash. They're put into a pastella, a slurry of flour and water, then rolled into breadcrumbs and fried in a pot. I recommend using a thermometer attached to your pot to fry your arancini. We're going to do them in canola oil, but there's our saffron rice. There's our ragu with this one here. Has shredded mozzarella and our pea. All three of them have peas, but they're done differently with their meat filling. This is sausage with the mozzarella. This one is eggplant and ricotta salata grated into that. And this one is prosciutto di Parma with an Alfredo sauce. And there is some baby fresh mozzarella. All right, here we are. It's the next day. We let our arancini refrigerate overnight. And they're nice and firm. Over here we have our pastella and our Italian breadcrumbs. We already used our thermometer to check the well, and it's right at 350. So we're going to get started here and get one of these arancini in the slurry. So what you want to do is you really want to get it covered in the slurry as such. And then once you get it, the slurry all around that, you're going to then roll it in some breadcrumbs and get it covered in the breadcrumbs nice and lightly. Okay. And then you're going to gently lower that into the oil without getting your fingers into the oil. All right, so our arancini are coming out beautiful. All right, to plate the arancini, I took a little bit of our zucchini and squash, a little bit of onion, and I'm grilling it here in this pan. That's about done. I'm gonna turn the burner off. We've got some our leftover puttanesca sauce here. So what you wanna do is just take the arancini, place that right in the center, put a nice little presentation on that, and just take your grilled vegetables and arrange them around your arancini, your rice balls. Isn't that beautiful? Basil right now is hard to come by, but mint was so much easier to come by. And there is your arancini, your rice balls, Sicilian style.